Hi, this is Paul Salt from iPhone Dev TV. We're going to go ahead and get started with this tutorial. We're going to create our very first iPhone app if you haven't done that already. And let's get going. So let's create a new Xcode project by clicking this button. And we'll go application and then single view application. Then we'll hit next. We'll give it a name. We'll call this one bouncing labels. And we're going to go with all the default settings here. So pause the video if you want to look at what I have. You can make up stuff with your own name. Doesn't really matter too much right now. This is just a learning experience. We'll go with Swift and Universal to start. Again, that really doesn't matter as long as we're sticking to Swift because that's the language that we'll be using. Now, I put this in my projects folder, which is on my desktop. So you can see my desktop up here and my projects folder. So if you don't have a folder, you can always create a new folder right down here in the bottom corner. And we're going to turn off Git. We're not going to use Git for our experimental projects when we're just learning how to get started. But Git is a good option when you're working on a bigger project where it's really important that you track your changes so that if you mess something up, you can go back and start over. So let's go ahead and hit create and get started. So the first thing that we're going to do in this video is create our labels, and then we're going to customize them a little bit so that we can actually see them on the screen. And we're going to do this all in code. So what I want you to do is head on over to the left side here and click on viewcontroller.swift. This is our code file that we're going to start in. And then within here, we are going to look at our viewDidLoad method. And right underneath this comment, which has the double slashes, we will add our first lines of code. And what I'm going to put here is another comment for myself. So here I want to create the labels. And in order to use these labels, we're actually going to create some IVARs. These are instance variables. And these are going to be our labels. So this is actually going to be the very first thing I do. And this is right under the view controller. Now, before I get any further, I want to show you how I've customized Xcode to show the line numbers on the left, because these are not on by default. So go up to Xcode, then preferences. And then what you're going to do is navigate to text editing, and then you'll click this line number. So let me just show you how this works. I'll click on line numbers up here at the top, and that will hide and show it for you. Okay, so let's leave that on because that makes it a lot easier to talk about where to put code. So the first thing I want to do is I want to create an IVAR for our first label. And a variable or an IVAR, what I'm talking about here is an instance variable. So this is a term that's new. And anytime I introduce a new term, what I want you to do is write it down in your notebook so that you can come back to it and fill in the blanks later on. So leave some space, write down instance variable, write down variable, and write down a Swift code file. Those are some good starting points, and you can start to fill in the blanks as we go. So we're going to use the var keyword, and then we're going to give it a name. So here we'll call it my first label. Then we're going to put a colon here, and we're going to do a space, and then write UI label. And you'll see that autocomplete is suggesting stuff as we're typing. And after that, we're going to put an exclamation mark. Now, we'll talk more about the exclamation mark a little bit later, but to get started, we'll just go with that. Next, I'm going to create another one, and we'll call this one iPhone label. So as you saw in the example, we had two labels on the screen, so we're going to create two variables here to represent those. And they're both going to look like this. So pause the video if you're still typing. Make sure that it looks like this. You shouldn't see any red. There should be no errors. If you do anything like this and we run it, you'll see that there's some red here. Go ahead and correct anything so that it matches exactly what I write. Now, you have to remember, this is very case sensitive, so if you have a capital letter or a lowercase letter in the wrong place, things won't work. So go ahead, fix any issues. Now let's create our labels. So our first step up here was to create some instance variables or IVARs. Our next step is to actually create the label. So we declared them, and I should make that a little bit more clear. So we'll just call this declare IVARs. Then we'll create the labels down here. And what I'll say here is we'll start with just the my first label. My first label is equal to UI label. and we're going to call its initializer. So it's init method, and we do that by invoking a method call here, and that's with the open parentheses, close parentheses. So just write that, and we're well on our way to getting this label started. So the next step is we want to add text to the label. So the label has an attribute. This is called a property, and we can set it to a string of letters. So we represent strings or text in code using the quotation mark. So we'll use the double quotation mark. And here I will say my first. And that's it. There are no semicolons, as you've seen already. We don't use semicolons in Swift. They're not required. You can use them if you're in the habit of writing C or Objective-C code, but you don't need them here. Next, we will want to customize the font. So we can say something like myFirstLabel.font is equal to a font. So there's a class called UIFont. Write this down if you don't know what this is. And we're going to go with the system font of size. And here we pass in the font size. To start, we'll go with 36. Now, you can play with whatever values you want. It's really good to experiment and see how things look. Now that we have a font, let's go ahead and add this to the screen. So what we need to do here is we have this attribute called view in our view controller, and there's a method on this that's called addSubView. So a method is a chunk of code that we can run, and what this will do is this will make it so that our label will appear on the screen on our iPhone. So I'm gonna go ahead and add it, and then we're gonna hit the run button up top. I use the keyboard shortcut that was Command R. I recommend you learn them. And right now we see the iPhone screen, but we see no label. So there's a problem here. That problem is we have the text, we have the font, but we never set a size for this label. And there's an easy way to do that using a method call on the label. So we can do myFirstLabel.sizeToFit, and that will resize based on the text that we have as well as the font size. So depending on how big it is in terms of font size is going to make our label bigger or smaller. Now we see that our label is at the very top corner here, and it's kind of covering up our status bar. So in order to get this to move around, we're going to have to change its center position. So what I'm going to do on line 26 is just say myFirstLabel.center is equal to some new point. And so we can create a point like a Cartesian 2D coordinate point using the cgPoint constructor or the initializer, and we do that with the open parentheses, and then you'll see autocomplete here. Now I can use the up and down arrows to switch between these two. We can just go with this top one right here with the CG floats, and this is just going to be a value. So typically you'll use integer values, because if you use non-integer values, you can get some blurring in your iPhone apps, and that's no good. So let's go ahead and add some value. I'm going to go with around 100 for our x coordinate, and then around maybe 40 for our y coordinate. So right now it's at 0, 0. We're going to stop up top by hitting this button right here, and then we're going to hit play again to start it up again. So now you see that our label shifted right over here, and that's looking a little bit better. So let's go ahead and create our second label. So our second label is called iPhone label. And the first thing we need to do is create it. Now, what happens when we don't do this step? I'm just going to write it here, but I'm going to comment it out using the command forward slash shortcut. That allows me to quickly turn on or off a line of code so that it doesn't actually run. If I try to use the iPhone label without initializing it, let's see what happens. So I'm going to call this my first iPhone app. That's going to be the text that we're going to display. And up top, I'll just hit the run, and this will start it up. And all of a sudden, we have a crash. So you'll see thread one, exec, bad instruction. Now, this is no good, and you're probably wondering what you can do. Well, the first thing to look at is this error message. The second thing to look at is this error message down here. And you can see that error message by looking for this tab. This will toggle this view on, and we really just care about this right here. This is the error message that you're going to want to look at, and you're going to have to try to figure out, okay, what did I do wrong? So look at the name of the variable, the type up here. This is technically an optional that's been force unwrapped, so it's it's expected to always be valid, and it's not valid because we didn't actually create it, so that's why it crashed. So to fix that issue, all you have to do is make sure that you create the UI label using this line of code. Now we'll stop it and run it again, and that shouldn't crash. But we're not going to see the new label because we haven't finished setting it up. So let's go ahead and say iPhone label dot font is equal to UI font, and let's go with a bold font. So I can do bold system font of size, and let's make it a little bit bigger. So we'll do 48, then we'll size it to fit. So iPhone label that size to fit, that'll resize it. And again, we can add this to our subview to see what it looks like right now, and then we can work on positioning it. So I'll add iPhone label. And when we add it to the subview, it just adds it to our iPhone app canvas. So now we see it, it's overlapping a lot of stuff. Still not quite right. So let's shift it down and to the right. So let's pick a position somewhere over there. So iPhone label dot center is equal to a CG point. Now this is just a point. It's an X and Y coordinate. And we're going to go with the CG float one. And in here, my X coordinate was 100 for the other one. So let's go 200 for this one. And then Y, we could do 200 as well. So let's see where this puts it. I'm going to run it again using that shortcut command R. And you can see it's really low. It's a little too low for me. I want this sort of how I want it laid out as it's going to drop. So I'm going to go with something like 90. And we'll go ahead and run that again and see how it looks. All right, so if you're still typing, pause the video right now. Type in the rest of the code. You want to make sure it's case sensitive. Make sure that it matches. And then you should see the output that we just saw. All right, so now that you've got that, you should be able to run the app and you will see the two labels up here at the top. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to add some animation so that we can start making these fall down and bounce a little bit and have a little bit of spring with the physics system that's built into iOS.